This is urgent. We have breaking news, urgent news. China crashes, Bitcoin crashes, the housing market crashes. Basically, I'm covering all three. And I know you guys have been saying, hey, haven't you been saying this for like the last couple of months that Evergrande's going to crash or that it's crashing? Well, yes. And because I have my magical crystal ball. And yesterday I stood corrected because you said, hey, you have balls. And let me get my wife in on this one. Hey, babe, do you have your purse with you?
Yes.
Okay. Please explain to my audience about what's in your purse.
I keep one and you keep
one. I don't know if the audio picked that up. And just to let you guys know, I may act like a weak beta male, but the truth be told, I am actually an alpha dog. You can even ask my wife, babe, would you agree with me that I am red pill aware alpha dog?
No, you're my beta.
You cannot use profanity on the channel. Pop the confetti.
And there you go again. I tell you what to do, but it's so cute how you.
But enough of the physical abuse that I endure daily in this thing that they call marriage. Evergrande declared, finally, gosh, how long did we have to wait for them to finally give? It's like back in school, you give, huh? You give in default. It's done, kaput, as huge restructuring looms. So they're gone. Now Kaiser's gone. 400 million bond. That's a lot of money. Bond payment. And some of you guys might be saying, you know what? What happens in China stays in China. That doesn't affect us. How is that going to affect the Bitcoin market? How is that going to affect the housing market? How is that going to affect the stock market? I am telling you, and I have been telling you, that what happens over there, come on, happens over here too. And their housing market is really rolling over. Well, but we're different, Bravo. We're America, Texas. We're only, everyone's coming here. It's only going to go up.
The wild real estate ride that we have experienced here in North Texas hasn't just cooled down. It's finally over, according to some experts. One researcher I spoke with says the unprecedented boom was not going to last forever.
So cue the fire. The game is coming to an end for all of you that are like, oh, you're always wrong. I'm like, oh, well, until I'm not. And I'll tell you, it actually gets very difficult because when you are at the top and I'm like, you know what? That's it. I'm selling my real estate. I'm getting out. People are like, what are you talking about? Are you crazy? No, I'm not crazy. I have just done this before. And I'm going to actually explain this to you. What happened to me in the past? What is happening again? Evergrande restructuring puts bondholders, ooh, at Beijing's mercy. And now we get to the, do we pay you 10 cents on the dollar? Do we pay you 5 cents on the dollar? Let's see. Let's listen. Let me just click.
China, Evergrande, default. We've been waiting for that D word for a while, Damon. It comes and it's just like,
Yeah, we've been waiting for the D for quite a while. One moment. Well, and it looks like China just gave you the big D.
What next? What next, Damien?
The news that everyone's been waiting for. So look, I mean, look, yes, restricted default. Fitch placed both Evergrande and Kaisen restricted default overnight. And look, you know, that's about $30 billion in offshore bonds, which are now subject to cross defaults. And so we're going to see how it all shakes loose. For me, it's good.
So $30 billion, and the whole market is always bond. You guys always, and I'm going to go into Bitcoin. We're going to look at the bond market. I'm going to go into stonks. Look at the bond market. The bond market predicts all. Let's see if they just have anything interesting to say. It looks like by me hitting the space bar, the answer would be don't hit the space bar.
Going to be, you know, prioritizing creditors. And if you look at our friends at Marathon, Ashmore, UBS, Allianz, BlackRock, all of which own these bonds, they probably have very low expectations of what they're going to get paid back, especially after the seven-member credit risk committee was formed with the Guangdong provincial government, or two entities therein, sitting on the board. They're going to prioritize employees. They're going to prioritize homeowners, suppliers, and offshore creditors are going
to. And to think how many homeowners, like, people are waiting for their houses. Can I have my house, please? I just gave you all my money. No, we don't get it. And also, just to let you know, these housing markets don't crash like overnight. Oh my gosh, my house was worth $1 million. Now it's 500,000. Well, I wish someone would have told me. No, it takes time, but I will give you that. Like, look, the NASDAQ down, S&P 500 down, Tesla down. It takes time. And then we go from crazy frenzy, right? Standing in line, camping out, to just, you know what, just can you, someone, please make an offer on my home? I'll take anything. But then again, all housing markets are different. There's no housing market. There's lots of markets amongst the houses. And back in 08, I had a rude awakening. I actually had investment, Texas. I had properties in Texas, California. I was doing loans. I was the big man on campus. Well, until cue the fire, I wasn't. I made a loan. I gave a guy bad credit. He was building up north, and $100,000 cash. Here you go. Go build your little thing. And then I was like, whoa, 30 days. He's going to pay me back with interest. Actually, it was double. I put my life on it. It was double. $100,000. He did it once. The second time, I got this little, unzipped the FedEx thing, and it said default. And I was way down the list of chain of command of when I was going to get paid back. Fortunately, 30 days goes by. This was just out of the blue. Another knock on the door, signed for it. Oh my gosh, my money. And we'll just call that my red candle on the monthly moment, which I shall show you in the stock market momentarily. And after that scare, I lost sleep at night. I remember just staring at ceiling tiles, even though I didn't have ceiling tiles, whatever was up there, light fixtures. And with all the warnings that were going on, inverted yield curve, you name it, warning. Everyone's like, no, the market can only go up. I'm like, that's it. Clear it all out. And I remember the month and the year, October 2008, I was completely out of all rental properties, my own homes, everything, on the streets, homeless. And 6 months ago on this channel, I said, that's it, I am out again. Sold everything and sold my property in California, got out. Now, you guys, everyone's still like, you're stupid. Why would you do that? Oh my gosh. Newsom's, you know, Jesus. So you got God running the place, or a guy with God complex, one or the other. It's pretty much the same thing. I'm like, I don't care. And then you guys are like, even your friends running for governor, it will all be better. I'm like, no, I'm out. I have learned in life, there is a time to take profit and everyone will be against you. And I'll tell you, I don't want to be the guy holding the bond or the bag when there's a restructure, or when they downgrade and then they default. Like, I don't want to be that guy. But on the good news, you have subscribed. Did you yet? Or can you guys also check? Because you guys are hitting me up in the comments section saying like, they unsubscribed me. Can you believe that? And no, I don't delete comments. None of that. I don't do that. You guys can rip on me all you want. It's okay. I just leave it dangling in the wind for you just to make fun of it. I will make fun of it. You can make fun of it. We all come along as one great, big, happy family. But if I go away, if you don't click the like button or, you know, all those other things, in which, you know, at some point I'm going to be gone. You just know it. Everyone's like, you still here? They still letting you tell the truth? And you don't even want to say this word. These guys, woo-hoo-hoo, all the elites, everyone's zoop, billionaires, you name it. Don't want to talk about China. But their vegetable prices are surging 30%, 31% in 1 month. Do you not see that these things are going to affect the people? Do you not think that the people will rage? So now they're losing their houses, they're losing their investments, and this is like their entire economy is in this Ponzi scheme. And the government's like, I don't like this Ponzi scheme. We're not going to do this anymore. I mean, this is just like a blender of dynamite and matches, just let it go. It's like, does it blend? Throw in, I don't know, an iPhone, maybe an Android, if you don't like Android, and just blend that thing. This is not good. And actually, if you want the literal translation of it, this isn't good. Here, I copied it for you.
Buhao.
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 Buhao. Also known as and gun. And for those of you that are like, what are these references? I get so confused all the time. What is this and gone thing you keep talking about? And this is Stanley. And his father is telling me, Stanley, put it all in the bank. It'll be safe. It's fine. They'll just, you know, it'll end up in the repo market, basically. But here.
I got a $100 check from my grandma, and my dad said I need to put it in the bank so it can grow over the years.
Well, that's fantastic. A really smart decision, young man. We can put that check in a money market mutual fund. Then we'll reinvest the earnings into foreign currency accounts with compounding interest, and it's gone.
Gets me every time.
What?
It's gone. It's all gone.
And actually, it's even funnier the more you understand the monetary system. When you deposit said whatever into the bank account, they actually look at that as a liability. The bank's like, oh, we don't want these liabilities. We want to turn them into assets. So they sell them or they exchange it for an asset. So for everything, 100%, no reserve requirements, which China, I think they've changed their little tune on that one. But for those of you that are new to the channel, everything that you put into the bank is gone. And I'm telling you, with the way the system is set up, the monetary system and gone, it is going to affect you. It's currently affecting China. You like 30%? 6% is devastating to everyday Americans. Yes, but not the everyday Americans that own yachts, because you have the have yachts and then you have the have nots. Rising prices need to be curbed. Oh, because I'm sure our government officials will step right in and curb that. And then finally, inflation is here to stay. Thanks, Fed. But now I come bringing balance because I believe it is all deflationary. Well, remove the government. At some point, the people will. And if you want to know when that's going to happen, just keep raising the prices. Where the people are like, enough is enough. I don't understand what is going on, but we're done. And also, you guys, it's bad. It's getting bad. It's going to get worse. You need to protect yourself. You need to start making plans. Look, I can't even believe this guy, the LA Police Protective, allowed this guy to even speak this on Fox. I know you're like, well, it's Fox. Listen to this for 1 second, and then you could put the two together and figure out why I left.
Who are just clueless on what's going on in the United States. There's rampant crime everywhere. And in fact, Los Angeles is like the movie Purge. But instead of 24 hours to commit your crime, they have 365 days to go out and commit their crimes. And that's how it is right now in Los Angeles and in San Francisco.
And I know some of you guys are like, well, it's fine here where I live in Monowi, population of one. I don't know what you're talking about, Bravo. It's perfectly fine. We don't have homeless problems. I don't know what this guy. No. But I'll click the like. And by the way, that is Nebraska, just in case you want to go there. And maybe they'll put a number two. I've never met one person from Monowi that I've ever liked. Actually, I might even use the word hate. I'm balanced on that word. But let's take a look, because we've just housing market, roly-roly. China, roly-roly. Stock market, Bitcoin, uh-oh. So let's take a time machine and go back. Bitcoin, what are we? 2017, 2016. See, this is on the monthly. That's a red candle. That is your first warning sign. It's bigger than a warning sign. It's like the sign was bashed over the top of your head, okay? What happened? Bear market. But Bitcoin went up today, Bravo. Okay. All right. Let's pull back and look. We kind of had a slight sell-off from peak to trough. And if you want me to measure it for you, because you're into that, you're into size, only 85%. That's it. Remember that. Watch that big one red candle in your face. Another on the monthly red candle. What do? Bear market. You guys remember that? Well, now we're here. Oh, let me come up here. You guys remember the last bear market? I do, kind of very, 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 very clearly in my head. We had a little fake out, but wait, there's more. That was actually in April of this year, and I got really scared. But I'm like, I'm not buying it that this bull market is over. Peak to trough, lost 55%. And in all transparency, I put in a buy at 31 and some change. I know it was my last possible buy. It was a reversal on the MACD. The oscillators crossed, and I said, I'm taking a swing with this one. Pulled up my Fibonacci. And if you are interested in learning all those cool words, I have a Crypto Stocks University course. I know it says 1,000. I'm filming it. It's 200. Link in the description. Goes to 300. Dominate stocks. If you are brand new to the market, you start with this one. This is swing trading. This is what I taught high school, college. This is where you get your go-go juice from. And then you can move your go-go juice into this. This is more deep TA and crypto. But please, for the love of Buddha, do not swing trade crypto. You can momentum. You have to have so many indicators. You got to. No, don't do it. Don't think you're going to trade off my Bravo 9 and be like, oh, and score. Because it'll kind of be like, and gone. Like this this picture I just drew right here, right? See it? See, he's like, oh, that will be you. But back to this chart, looking at this, see that red candle? That was your first warning shot fired. You have 22 days. If this closes a red candle, I will take, because I have my trading crypto and then I have my HODL crypto. I'm actually going to move maybe soon all of my HODL crypto to USD. But Bravo, all of my channels, all my crypto channels are telling me this is like the end of the cycle. We're waiting for this thing to go. No, stop. And here, let me help you with something also. Gosh, I don't mean to FUD. Not at all. Guys, I think it's life-changing. I think those that are in crypto, life-changing. But do you want to buy at said bottom, or do you want to take the top? Me personally, I'm a top guy. No, not a bottom guy. But if you looked at my wife, you'd probably speak differently. Because her booty brings all the boys to the yard. And actually, as I'm saying that, my wife walks by. Babe, can I ask you a question?
Sure.
She has no idea what I'm going to say. Does your booty bring all the boys to the yard?
Absolutely.
And what did they call you in high school?
Charmin.
Did you hear how she said Charmin? She's like, Charmin. Because she knew, she hated that. She's like, stop it. But back to above my head. You're welcome that I just air out all of my stuff and my wife's stuff on this channel. It works really well in therapy. You guys are costing me. My last trades, I'll walk you through. I mean, as far back is there. And I told you, somewhere in the, 31 range. Where was it? The MACD. MACD, let me move it for you so you can see. It was May 31st. This is where I took out a buy. And you're like, oh, you lost, buddy. Okay, here, I'll show you. That was a position I took out. I actually held that position. Now, if you were to turn on the Fibonacci's, which I don't want to right now, just trust me, I called the top. Booyah. I got out on that one. I was out. Re-entered back in. And on this trade, just to let you know, it was around 50%, 55%, 53%. That was at whoop over there. Then on this channel, all right, put that in your head. I'm terrible at math. You're like, why do you trade? You guys know I put a buy in there. Why? Do you see that? MACD crosses. We're above. That was a descending triangle. It broke. I'm like, it breaks that green line. Here we go again. What did I do after that? When did I take profits? That when it gets a little gray. And I'm being honest. But I'll tell you, I did. Yes, I made that trade. I said this was a bull flag here, right here. Added to a position on that one, held that position. And I'm sorry, I do trade a lot, so sometimes it gets like, what was it? I remember I took a loss on this one, added to it, and I said this green line right here. But I mean, if you add it all up, trust me, we're up. I said if it crosses this line, which I closed at, it was like 51 and some change. I said, outsies. So it was this bull flag up here. I didn't do too well on that one. And on this one was about 18%. So on this trade, I took about a 20% loss on the down. This was my bull flag. Started to play out, reversed. That's it. And I've told you, I've been wanting to take a trade out. There's just nothing. Nothing looks good to me. And something that you need to know about, some trades good, some trades, same thing with swing trading. It's like win, lose, win, lose, win, right? It's the winners that'll just make up for all the losers. Remember that, ladies. Sometimes you got to go through all those losers to find that winner. And then you check his credit card. You check his balances. You check everything. Then you allow ring to said go on finger. And also, ladies, all 10 of you on this channel, my wife, which I've been teaching her how to trade. Here you go. I said she's trading on the daily. I don't know if she decided 4-hour daily. It depends on her time. She almost took out a buy, but she's like, look, it's early. I just want to beat it. I'm like, nope, nope, nope. Wait for confirmation. Oh, sell-off continues. We also have a divergence, a slight divergence. Look, look, on the, see this? On the weekly, going down, price kind of going up. Well, the price really figured that one out, right? Priced it right in. But also, let me just go back on the monthly so you can see it. The two big, fat red candles. I know, guys, I'm telling you, you got to close up, up, up. You have 22 days left, man. If that wasn't a warning, let's just take, you guys want to take a look at the MACD? Huh? Maybe? Don't mean to FUD here. Just, please, I am not Elmer, and I am not here bringing FUD. I'm not Elmer. I'm not here bringing FUD. But there's just one thing that I want you to miss, and that would be that boulder that just missed me. So that is all I do on this channel. I'm just like, hey, look up there. There's a big boulder, but it's not even moving, Bravo. And not just that, we have Janet and we have Jerome to protect us, protect our wealth. But at the end of the day, I just don't want you, because you're like, here's all my stoof and gun. I don't want that happening to you. So there it is. And learn how to do it. So you don't even need, let's say YouTube, poof, I'm gone. That means my courses are everything gone. Well, I mean, unless you already bought, then your lifetime forever. For 200, I cannot believe you're not taking advantage of that. But that's okay, all right. When I'm gone, you're like, oh, wait, where'd it all go? Where'd Bravo go? He was just telling me what to do. No, only your wife tells you what to do. Because you are an alpha dog. And I will see you, well, tomorrow. Because I make videos every single day until they don't let me.